friends, welcome back to my channel and welcome back to another video in my WW Instant Pot series. I am so excited about the two recipes. They were absolutely outstanding, so delicious. My husband loved both of them. So if your husband, your wife, your kids are picky eaters, they are going to love these. It was so easy, a one pot cleanup for a delicious WW friendly dinner. So if you wanna see the two Instant Pot recipes that I have on the agenda for you in this video, then all you have to do is keep watching. For tonight's Instant Pot dinner, we are making healthy fried rice. I am very excited about this. Let me show you what is in tonight's dinner. So first, what is in our sauce for our fried rice is you will need some sugar-free maple syrup, some minced garlic, soy sauce, and sesame oil, and that's what's going to create the sauce. And then for the rice itself, you'll need avocado or olive oil, vegetable broth, brown rice, you could use white rice if you would rather, eggs, frozen mixed veggies, and just some green onions to garnish the top of your fried rice. And we are going to have ours with chicken, and I'm going to season it along with the fried rice with the Dax Asian Zing. You guys, if you have not purchased Dax, you have to. Their seasonings are amazing. There is no salt. There's no MSG, they are all natural, and literally what's in their seasonings is just whole ingredients. So spices, sesame seeds, dehydrated garlic, black pepper, and paprika. And that's it. That's all that is in their seasonings, and they taste delicious. And because they are salt-free, they don't cause any water retention, especially before weigh-in day. So Dax has about 20 different spices on their website. They'll tell you what's in the spices and what they recommend them for. But check it out. I do have a 10% off discount code for Dax. I'll put that here on the screen, and it is linked down in the description box below. Highly recommend Dax. Best seasonings I've ever had. So I'm gonna go ahead and season my chicken with the Dax Asian Zing. So let's get started on tonight's dinner. So the first thing that we need to do for our fried rice is we need to go ahead and dice up our green onion. We're gonna top our fried rice with some green onion. And then we're gonna go ahead and we're gonna dice up our chicken breasts really small as well, and then get them seasoned here in this bowl with the Asian Zing. So let's get everything cut up and ready to go. Once you get your chicken all diced up, I'm gonna go ahead and add in my Dax Asian Zing, and I'm going to put a couple of good size scoops in with my chicken, and then I'm just gonna use my hand just to make sure my chicken gets nice and coated in the seasoning. And then we'll get our rice started in the Instant Pot, and then we'll get our chicken going on the stove. So the first thing that we need to do is spray your Instant Pot very well with non-stick cooking spray. So I have it all over the sides and the bottom of my Instant Pot. To that, I'm going to be adding my 2 cups of vegetable broth, or I'm sorry, 1 cup of vegetable broth and 1 cup of my brown rice. And we are going to put our lid on and we're going to cook this on high pressure for 26 minutes. And while this is cooking, we'll get started on our chicken. For the sauce for our fried rice, we are going to take 1/4 cup of soy sauce. I have the light or the reduced sodium soy sauce. We are also going to add 1 teaspoon of sugar-free syrup. And we are going to add 1 teaspoon of sesame oil. And then we are going to add 1 teaspoon of minced garlic. And we're gonna give this a nice big stir. And we're gonna go ahead and put this in the fridge, set this aside until our fried rice is done. But that is so easy. That is going to be the sauce for your fried rice. After we've made our sauce, we are getting our chicken started. So I just sprayed my pan with some nonstick cooking spray. I've added in that delicious chicken with the Asian zing. And I'm just going to cook this over medium heat until it is cooked through, and then I'll pump up the heat and get it nice and crispy. And we'll just add this in with our fried rice. Once your Instant Pot turns off after your 26 minutes, we are going to let this naturally release for about 10 minutes, and then we'll go ahead and take the top off, and we're gonna remove the rice from our Instant Pot. Let me show you what our completed cooked chicken looks like. I'm just keeping it warm until our fried rice is done. So here is our Asian Zing chicken. It looks so good, it smells so delicious. So I'm just keeping this warm, and then once our fried rice is all done, we'll put together our completed dinner. So I just pulled the lid off our rice. It's perfectly done. We are gonna go ahead and transfer it into a separate bowl here because we need to cook down the rest of our fried rice ingredients, our veggies and our eggs. But look at that, perfect rice out of the Instant Pot every time. So I've removed all the rice and I've turned it on to the saute function. I'm going to add 2 teaspoons of my avocado oil to the bottom of my Instant Pot. I'm gonna let that warm up for just a couple seconds, and we're gonna toss in our vegetables. Once your Instant Pot has warmed up, we're gonna go ahead and toss in our mixed veggies, and we're gonna let those cook down for just a few minutes. I did let them kind of defrost while the rest of our rice and chicken we're cooking, so we're just going to get these starting to cook down a little bit before we add in our eggs. Once your vegetables have warmed through, you're going to go ahead and push them off to one side of your Instant Pot, and to the other side we're going to add 2 eggs, and I went ahead and already cracked them. And we're gonna allow those to cook down. We wanna stir them constantly because we do want those nice, you know, egg bits that you find in fried rice. So once our eggs get cooked down, we'll start reincorporating the rest of our fried rice ingredients. Now that our eggs are cooked through, I'm gonna mix those in with my vegetables just to make sure they're not sticking to the bottom of our Instant Pot. And now we're gonna add back in our chicken and our rice. And we're gonna give that a big stir, get everything nice and mixed together. We still are on the saute function for just another minute or so. You could turn it off, your Instant Pot is still hot enough, but I went ahead and left it on the saute function. And then the last thing we're going to do is add in that sauce that we made. And we are gonna mix that in with our fried rice. And that's it, you guys, it's done. All in one pot minus the chicken. The recipe, the original recipe doesn't call for chicken. I just decided to add that just so that it made a complete meal versus just a side dish. So there you have it. Instant Pot fried rice that looks delish. Let me get this plated up and then I'll give you the smart points. So here's our completed Instant Pot fried rice. It couldn't have been any easier. I love my Instant Pot so much, and you guys, this rice is so good. I took a bite. It is better than a Chinese food restaurant. This is a full-size dinner plate. This is 1/6 of the fried rice. This entire plate of fried rice is only 5 smart points. 0 points for the chicken. The Dax seasoning is 0 points. So the only thing you have to count for is the rice and the oil that we use, the sesame oil and the avocado oil. So this entire plate, 5 smart points. For tonight's Instant Pot dinner, we are going to be making light cream cheese chicken pasta. So excited for this. Let me show you what's in tonight's dinner. So first you're going to need some chicken broth, cream of chicken soup, fat-free cream cheese. I'm gonna add some zucchini just for a vegetable in my pasta. This is not in the original recipe, I just added it to it. Of course, some chicken, and a package of zesty Italian recipe salad dressing mix. And then for pasta, we're gonna be using Fiber Gourmet. This is my favorite pasta in the whole world. This is the spaghetti. You can have 2 ounces of this pasta for 3 smart points. Traditional pasta is 6 smart points, 5 to 6 smart points for 2 ounces. So this pasta is half the smart points. It tastes delicious. It's the only pasta we use. It's all my husband asks for. He doesn't want the other pasta. He prefers the Fiber Gourmet. And it is a WW game changer, you guys. Half the smart points of regular pasta and it tastes exactly the same. So I'm gonna be using the light spaghetti. We are gonna cook this separately from our chicken in our Instant Pot, but check out Fiber Gourmet. It is on the Netrition website. Down in the description box is a link. It'll take you directly to the site. You can search around. There's a ton of WW-friendly items on that site, but this one is a must-have. So let's get started on tonight's dinner. So to get started on tonight's dinner, we're gonna go ahead and take your chicken broth. We wanna put just about a quarter of an inch coating on the bottom of our pan, and that is just so that our chicken doesn't stick in the cooking process. And then go ahead and take your chicken breasts, and we're gonna put those into our Instant Pot. And I'm gonna put them in as whole chicken breasts. I'll probably end up shredding them once they are done cooking. To that, we are going to add our zesty Italian seasoning mix right over the top of our chicken. And then we're also going to go ahead and add in our cream of chicken soup as well. And I'm just gonna kinda nicely spread that out over the chicken. And then we'll put our Instant Pot lid on, and we're gonna cook this for about 15 minutes, and then we're gonna allow it to naturally release for about 5. So let me get this all in here. And then we'll add in our zucchini and we'll be good to go. I went ahead and cut up my zucchini, and I'm just going to place it just right over the top of the chicken. It'll steam in the process of cooking the chicken, and our zucchini should come out perfect. So I'll get this put in there. We'll get our lid on and get this started. So I went ahead and put the lid on. We set it on manual for 15 minutes, and then we're just going to allow it to naturally release. So I'll be back in a flash. In the meantime, we're gonna get our pasta going on the stove. While our chicken and zucchini are cooking in the Instant Pot, I have my Fiber Gourmet spaghetti here about to a boil. I'm gonna go ahead and let this cook down, drain it, rinse it, and we'll be ready to add it to our Instant Pot along with our cream cheese. I just took the lid off. Look at this chicken, yum. Oh, it looks so good. So I'm just gonna take a couple of forks here and I'm just gonna kinda shred up my chicken just a little bit in the mix. You don't wanna drain that chicken soup or anything. We're actually gonna add some cream cheese and our pasta. So I'm just gonna go ahead and shred it up just directly here in my Instant Pot. It just makes it quick and easy. And once I get all the chicken shredded, I'll show you the next step. Once you get your chicken shredded, I did kind of big chunks of chicken. We are going to add in 8 ounces of fat-free cream cheese. I did turn my Instant Pot on to saute. That just keeps it warm so that this cream cheese can get nice and melted. Now, if your cream cheese thickens it too much, I do have some water here on the side that I can add in, but I have quite a bit of liquid between the chicken broth and the soup that I think we're gonna be okay. So I'm gonna let this cream cheese just kind of cook down and mix in, and then we'll add in our pasta. I'm also going to add just a little bit of salt and a little bit of pepper to this as well. We really like pepper, so you can't go wrong adding pepper into any dish. So I'm gonna go ahead and add a little bit of pepper. I'm gonna keep stirring till the cream cheese is melted, and then we'll add in our pasta. Once your cream cheese is melted, we're gonna go ahead and add in our pasta. And then we're gonna give it a good mix and we'll be ready to serve. Now, since I added the zucchini, you could serve this with an additional vegetable if you choose to, but I think that we're just gonna serve it as is with the chicken and the pasta and the zucchini. But look at that, you guys. Yum, it simulates an Alfredo with that cream cheese and that chicken, and that Italian seasoning will give it such good flavor. So look at that, yum. So I'm gonna go ahead and get this plated up and I'll be back to give you guys the smart points. And I do wanna point out before I plate this up that you can have a lot of this for the smart points. So wait until you see what our dinner looks like, but definitely excited. So here is our completed cream cheese, chicken, and pasta. This is a full-size dinner plate. So you can have 1/4 of the entire recipe. So almost a full-size dinner plate of pasta and chicken and cream cheese for only 6 smart points. This entire dinner with the Fiber Gourmet pasta, 6 smart points. So definitely order that pasta. You're gonna save a ton of smart points and it tastes absolutely delicious. So I'm gonna go enjoy my 6 smart point Instant Pot dinner. Thank you for joining me on another WW Instant Pot series video. I hope you enjoyed these 2 recipes. They were so incredibly delicious. I cannot wait to hear how much your family loves them. They're husband approved, you guys. You can't beat when you are 2 for 2 in husband approval. So if you're interested in the recipes, they are down in the description box below. As usual, if you're new to my channel, I'd like to welcome you. Extend a huge warm welcome to my YouTube friends and family. This is a fabulous place to be. I would love it if you would subscribe. And if you hit that bell, you'll be notified when I upload. That way you're not missing a single video. Give this one a thumbs up. Comment down below. Let me know, are you gonna try one or both of these recipes? You won't be disappointed. And I'll see you guys all in the next one. Bye.